Gas station owners are on notice that they are breaking the law. The owners of the stations near Orlando International Airport do not post prices and typically charge almost double the price of competing stations. WESH 2's Greg Fox live along Cimarron Boulevard in East Orlando with the story. Greg?
And this ongoing legal dispute between the city and the two gas stations out here, the Suncoast Energies and the Shell across the street on Cimarron Boulevard, escalated today with the issuing of citations. Now, they went out into the mail. And if they do not comply with the language in these citations, then they could face fines. Let's give you some background on this particular story here. For years, the gas stations near Orlando International have charged well above the going rate for fuel, hoping to catch people topping off their tanks on their rental cars. The rub is that there were no signs on the street telling drivers exactly what the gasoline costs. The city passed an ordinance demanding signs, and drivers tell us they are glad to now see it being enforced.
So I think they get you in here, and probably most people rental cars like mine and don't realize what they're paying until it's too late. Got to get to your flight.
They're tricking you out of your money.
Tricking you out of your money, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We're getting robbed without a gun.
Yeah, getting robbed without a gun, exactly.
Because the first sign ordinance was not properly noticed before council passed it, a judge issued a temporary injunction preventing the city from enforcing the new rules. Commissioners revoted and again passed the ordinance, which went into effect this past Monday. Now, if the Suncoast Energies and the Shell stations do not comply, they could face $1,000 a day fines, and that would begin after December 16th. So they've got 30 days here. I left messages with both attorneys representing these gas stations. Neither returned my call. Live near Orlando International in Orange County, Greg Fox, WESH 2 News.